Both sides have blamed each other for the fire at Europe's largest nuclear power station. For now, no spike in radiation levels have been detected, but with battles being waged nearby, it highlights the precarious nature of this war. A war in which Kyiv, in a surprise incursion into Russia's Kursk province, appears to have gained the upper hand. Ukrainian officials have been reticent with information about their troop movements, but their president, tacitly referring to his country's military gains as, quote, a fair response to Russian aggression.
Тільки від початку цього літа і тільки з районів Курської області по нашій Сумщині було завдано майже 2000 ударів артилерія, міномети, дрони. Ми фіксуємо і кожен ракетний удар. І кожен з таких ударів заслуговує на справедливу відповідь.
Those attacks reaching the capital Kyiv, Russian missiles left a trail of destruction. The Russian Defense Ministry releasing videos of what it said were Ukrainian targets in the Kursk region, even as Ukrainian missiles struck Russian buildings in the same area. Both sides preparing for retaliation, evacuating people from the border areas, the Red Cross helping thousands of people on the Russian side. Most told to move without much warning.
Калитку бігом закривають і через сади, і помчались неізвісно куди. Ми вибіжали, а куди? Що робити? І по вулиці, ходами, бух-бух-бух-бух, ну що робити?
On the Ukrainian side of the border, this man accepting his military tactics, but preferring to stay put as the war rages around him.
Дякую, підтримую. Те, що вони пішли, підтримую. Так і треба, хай вони почувствують, поживуть у нашій школі.
A new lot of displaced people as the war moves into what was once their homes. After steadily losing ground over recent months, Kyiv's forces have now managed to create optimism within their ranks. What's unclear is just how sustainable this offensive will be in the long term. Edmund Roy, SBS World News.